Mike, what more do we know about this decision that the photos remain a secret?
Well, in the end, Shep, the majority of the president's national security team was against releasing a photo. They felt like there was much more risk than reward if they were to release a photo to U.S. troops, American diplomats around the world, and also American interests. Now, what is not entirely clear is if a 9/11 family member were to ask the president to see a photo, if he would show it to them if they say it's part of their healing. Shep.
Maybe we'll find out here in New York tomorrow. We're learning more about how teams supposedly ID'd bin Laden's body.
Well, that's right. We knew DNA testing was part of the identification process. We've learned just a short time ago that DNA from bin Laden's mother and three of his sons was used to ID his remains to make the confirmation 99.9% certain that it was indeed Usama bin Laden, Shep.
You know, some lawmakers claim they saw a bin Laden photo. But now there are questions about whether it was the one that a lot of us saw on the internet that wasn't real.
That's right. One that ended up in my email and probably many people's emails. There's a lot of confusion on Capitol Hill. Some key lawmakers saying now they're not so sure. One of them, Senator Kelly Ayotte from New Hampshire, Congressman Mike Rogers, who is the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, says he's still convinced the photo he saw was legitimate. I can tell you a short time ago, there was a key briefing on Capitol Hill. Lawmakers asked to see a photo. They were not shown a photo. Their briefers from the Joint Special Ops Command and the CIA said they would need permission from the White House to show a photo to those members of Congress. Shep.
Mike Emanuel live on a beautiful night on the North Lawn. Mike, thanks so much.